All right, just finished up getting ready to make my way over to Magic Kingdom for Mickey's Not So Scary. It's about like 3:15-ish, so get there a little bit early. Definitely want to get a lot of the new treats that they have for this Not So Scary. Maybe try some of the ones, depends if I'm full or not, but try some of the ones that are available like all day long. Definitely want to get the exclusive ones. Maybe we'll hit a ride or two. And I definitely need to check out the shows. I'm not sure if I'll do any of the meet and greets because I know sometimes they get a little bit crazy, especially for Jack and Sally. But let's head over to Magic Kingdom. All right, made it in. Got my map, so it'll tell me where all the snacks are. So we'll head down this way, get our little candy bag, and go from there. And then the first character to greet us as we come in is Cruella De Vil.
A new coat. Right? I bring a dog. Imagine! Not me! You want to be seen walking around someone else's pet! No! That's the ticket! You better walk your outfit.
I got my trick-or-treat bag. This one's nice, nice purple one this year. It says let's boo this on the back with a little spooky castle there, but I think we'll just head maybe into Adventureland and then continue onward around the park and try out all the different snacks and then make a game plan for the rest of the night as well. And then once I'm over here, I wanted to take a look at Tiana's. This is the first time I'm seeing it like fully complete. Those look pretty good. I kind of like how they made it more foliage over how it used to look with more of the, I guess, more deserty kind of style. And then here's a look at the not so scary Halloween merchandise that they're advertising right here on the map. So you have the little ornament there, which is pretty neat. And then the spirit jersey for this year looks pretty cool as well. So I just wanted to take a quick peek at this map before we jump into it. A few different food items I know I wanted to try tonight. I just want to get a quick peek at those show times as well. So Boo to You Parade, 8:15, 11:15. So the later one's normally the better one to go to because there's going to be less people. A lot of people just want to see that right away and they'll be at the first showing. All right, since the party doesn't start until officially 6, so a lot of the things won't be available. But we'll take a nice relaxing ride here on the People Mover. It did start drizzling again though, so it might be a wet evening. I didn't bring a raincoat, so just gonna be a hat and a wet shirt. Here we go for another relaxing ride here. All right, here we are, we're moving. I think Joffrey's actually has a special drink for just Halloween in general, so I may pick that up after this. And I am starting to get a bit hungry, so it's going to work out perfectly. I'm hungry, and then I can start trying all these snack items and stuff like that. But I did notice a lot of the Halloween items, I don't know why Disney specifically, I guess, associates Halloween with spicy. So a lot of the things are spicy, so we'll see how spicy some of them are. I might not try everything because I think that Dole Whip sounds kind of gross, so I'm not going to try that. But open to trying a bit of the other things. Like I think there's spicy beignets I got to give a try to. And I have to head over to Friar's Nook. There's a few different items there I need to try. So, yeah, probably another 45 minutes or so.
Progress signals. Walt Disney's amazing dream for a community of tomorrow. Did you know Progress City inspired Epcot and a lot of the visionary ideas throughout Walt Disney World? Look, there's even a tiny People Mover.
Vehicles. Thank you.
I think I'll be skipping Tron entirely this trip. I don't know, just not a big of a fan of it. It's really quick of a ride. And I don't know, I feel like they could have done something else. Maybe a different futuristic like roller coaster to fit inside of Tomorrowland. And I'm probably gonna skip out on the overlay here at East Space Mountain. All they do is completely make it pitch black. So I think I'm okay skipping out on it. It is fun, but I think I'm gonna skip out and just focus on other things, you know, other treats and stuff like that, because Space Mountain's already pretty dark as is, so just shutting off a few extra lights doesn't really make too big of a difference. But yeah, I think I'm skipping it. See, as you can see, because right now the People Mover, it stopped, but we were right inside of Space Mountain. They did turn on some of the lights here on the People Mover, but it is super dark already, so it doesn't really make a difference whether you do the overlay or not. But yeah, hopefully they get this moving, because I think it's a little bit past 5, I think, right? Oh, it's almost 5 o'clock, so about an hour until the party officially starts, and then they could go on a snack-eating spree. All right, they finally got the People Mover moving. It was sitting here for quite some time. I was starting to get a little concerned, but we're on the move now. And then we'll get off to a little bit, just about 5 o'clock. So I'll hit Joffrey's real quick and then see which direction I want to head next. And wow, the rain is definitely coming down now. So might be switching to the action camera. Just definitely don't want to get this camera soaked, but yeah, it's pretty wet out. You know, it's a shame, but you know how Florida is. Like, it was just like completely sunny a few minutes ago, and now it's right back to rain, and it's raining pretty good. But that's unfortunately how Florida is, especially as you're coming into like the late August, September. It just has a lot of rain. Wow. I did not wear the right shoes for this either. Like, I thought it was going to be decent for the rest of the night, but doesn't appear to be so. So I have to find some cover once I get off the People Mover. I kind of wish we were still stuck now, but gonna have to figure it out. Yeah, just look at that.
Mike Wazowski has brought in some real monsters.
There's like puddles down there. I just feel bad for everyone that's like wearing their costumes, because like, especially if they're wearing like a costume material, those things are definitely not comfortable when they get like soaking wet. Or those people that have put out a little extra makeup on tonight. Hopefully it's waterproof makeup. All right, yeah, so switched over to the Action 4, at least until the rain dies down. So we'll keep kind of hopping to building, trying to stay as dry as possible. So we'll wait on the coffee for a little bit, because that's kind of out in the open. But we'll just continue on. We'll head over to like Fantasyland and try to just stay dry. I gotta avoid all these puddles and then continue on to Fantasyland. So it's starting to lighten up a little bit, so gotta, maybe I'll run over to the Small World to get on that, and then hopefully it'll completely stop the time I get off. Gotta get on a nice slow moving ride, try to kill some more time, wait out the weather. And now my shirt's all wet, so it's gonna be a nice damp night. All right, nice and wet, but I've arrived at the Small World. I might just keep it rolling on this camera so the footage looks a little bit dark, or a little bit more noisy in dark scenes. It's because I'm using the Action 4. I'm just going to leave the Pocket 3 in my bag for now. My bag's allegedly waterproof, so we'll see if that's true or not. Alright, made it on. It was a nice, like, 5-minute wait. Hopefully this shirt dries quick, because I'm pretty soaked. Donald Duck. Minnie Mouse, what their signs are saying. Alright, so I did play with the settings a little bit, so I think it looks a lot better than it did. Maybe a little bit darker in some of the shadows, but it's not going to be as like noisy as I saw in some of the footage I taken before with this in a low light setting like this. But Small World is a pretty dark ride. On this camera, we have to see how the colors look, because when I was looking at the other footage I took in the Mexico Pavilion when I was on the Grand Fiesta Tour, the colors on the camera looked like oversaturated, which it looked like super orange in some scenes. But then when I got it up to on my iPad to edit it. It actually didn't look too bad, so we'll see how like this scene looks, because I know there is a lot of like oversaturated colors, so we'll see if that like if it balances out better when it's on the iPad or not. But I mean, not too bad. I mean, for an action camera, normally they're used for like daytime footage. So like for it to be able to like do okay in low light, I think that's pretty impressive. Considering we look at this camera compared to the GoPro, it would be like pitch black in this setting. You would barely be able to see anything. There's the great Tom Sawyer's Island that'll be soon going bye-bye. Oh gosh, maybe it was a mistake coming down this way. It's like these huge puddles. Alright, got through them. Start off our Halloween treats. Got the sweet and spicy beignets from the Golden Outpost directly next to Tiana's and the chocolate caramel tartelettes. Give these a try. I'm going to try the beignet without the chocolate sauce that it comes with first, and then I'll try it with the chocolate sauce, and then I'm assuming that's just going to be super sweet, but we'll see how they taste. Just plain beignet. They're not really spicy. I'll try with the chocolate. I think they're better without the chocolate, to be honest. So yeah, so far, I think it just has more of that berry taste, because it's supposed to be like a berry and spicy taste, but mostly just taste the berries. This chocolate tart, let's just see how sugary this is. A little hard, but I think that's because it's like freshly been sitting in that freezer. But let's see. Pretty good. It's a kind of refreshing, definitely pretty sweet, but we'll see how it tastes. Let me try to get into the center where that caramel is. Oops, made a little bit of a mess here. So I'd pick a favorite out of these two. Just because it's so hot, I think I'll go with the tart, because it's a little bit cooler, a little bit more refreshing versus the beignets. So both are good. I would get both of these again if I had the option to. There, I was able to get front row on Pirates. I'm still using the Action 4, so if it does look dark, that is why. But yeah, front row for one of my favorite attractions here at Walt Disney World. All right, here we go, down the drop. Here we go. Whoa! Oh, God. Oh, that water's cold. Got a little bit more wet this time around than I normally do, but that can add to the mix of other water that's covered my body from the rain. Alright, so the cannonball got me good. So that like dropped a lot of water on me that time. But...
They toast to Boris and its many shiny rewards.
Alright, from Cosmic Rays, I ended up getting a Sinister Burger and the Witch's Fingers. These look pretty neat. For both of these came out to like $21.60, so not bad, and a cup of water. Gotta stay hydrated, it's getting hot out here. Here's a better look at that burger. So I think it's supposed to be spicy, you know, like everything's spicy for Halloween apparently. So let me give this one a try and see if it's good or not. I think last year I had the Cajun Burger from Pico Bill's, and I wasn't really that big of a fan of it, so we'll see if this burger is going to be good or not. It's not bad. The peanut butter sauce is a little bit weird of a taste, but not bad. I must say, I think I do like this more than the Cajun Burger, though, from last year. just if you don't like peanut butter or like a peanut flavor, then this like it's just gonna be disgusting for you, because that's pretty much you get a strong, like almost like you're biting into a peanut butter and jelly sandwich, and then there's a taste of like a hamburger in there. So if you don't, that's not your thing, then this won't be your burger.
All right, so let's try these witch's fingers now. Get a little bit of that, I don't know what was on the bottom, like that green stuff, but we'll give that a try. Oh, it's like a green apple pudding. It's not the worst thing, it's not the best thing. I would say it's like, if you were to rank this out of 10, I would say it's, I'll say like a 4.5 out of 10. And the burger, I would say, is maybe like, I'll say a 6.
All right, finished up the burger and a little bit more of the witch's fingers, but they, I don't know, they kind of lost its taste. Maybe they're lower. Maybe they'll say more like a 2 out of, maybe 2.5 out of 10. But we'll hit Buzz Lightyear, because I'm kind of full now, so we'll hit Buzz, and then we'll go from there. Alright, let's see if we can get to the Galactic Hero again. Done it a few times, but we'll see if I can do it again tonight. I feel like with these like neon colors, the camera footage looks pretty good on this. Alright, let's see what I can do in this room here. I want to try to get those volcanoes up there. So far, this isn't a good round. My car keeps spinning on its own, so it's a little bit of a struggle. All right, so 160,000 even. Not bad.
Remember, to infinity and beyond.
So 160 puts me in the planetary pile. I finished up with Buzz. So let me swing over to Joffrey's and see what they have. And then maybe I'll just make my way right back into the central hub and then see which way I can go next. From Joffrey's, it was a s'mores pumpkin like spice latte. We'll give this a try and see how it is. Not bad. Rather just pumpkin spice latte though. So it's nice to see that the sun finally came out tonight. It was so sunny earlier, then it was just this massive rainstorm and it kind of just lingered for a bit, but now sun's back out, so hopefully everyone could dry off. My shirt's pretty much dry for the most part. There's Stitch over there in his Elvis costume. So Tiana's is a 30 minute wait, so I think I'm just gonna hit it. I'm gonna get a little wet, but that's okay. Got plenty of time to dry off in this heat. Hell yeah, we'll hop on 30 minutes.
Last tune by the Blue Sky Social Club. This is When.
It's like right there. One time problem though, we still need to put together a band. If you want to help.
Tonight. The party's got just what we need.
like final viewings of the Liberty boat. And I've never seen the walkway in Frontier this bad before. Like, normally people come here and watch the parade, at least the first one here in Frontier, but normally this walkway is clear where you can at least semi-walk. I've been stuck here for the whole entire parade just trying to walk from Tiana's into the area where the Haunted Mansion is. Made it out of the mess, kind of. Semi-free. But yeah, that was bad. Like, if there was an emergency in there, like, it was impossible for anyone to get through. Alright, so I know I said I wasn't gonna go on really many rides, but I think after being close to that many people and everyone's like sweaty bodies against each other, I think I need to go to an attraction that has air conditioning, can relax a little. It's a little bit longer than a quick attraction, so maybe I'll see which one has a shorter wait and then we'll have to hit that, and then we'll see what else we're doing for the evening. But damn, that first parade, that was crazy. Outside the Little Mermaid ride, you have Ariel and Prince Eric doing their meet and greet. That I have a second to breathe. So I do think the Tiana's Art of Zoo is good, but I still do miss Splash Mountain. I feel like Splash Mountain, if you took the technology and stuff, the atmosphere, all that, that they put into Tiana's, and you put that into Splash Mountain, that would have been some crazy good ride, and I think it would have, would have made a lot of fans happy. But, I mean, Tiana's wasn't bad, but Splash Mountain will always have a special place in my heart. And if you haven't noticed by the queue back here, gonna hit Ariel's. Should be a walk on, and then get some air conditioning inside that ride, cool off a bit, and then continue on. Time to relax on Ariel. You know, I feel like this is an underrated ride. You know, it's pretty much the same as the Haunted Mansion, just Ariel themed. As for the rest of snack time, I don't know, might be all snacked out for the evening. I think I ate too much sweets. My tummy's a little upset, so I might have to lay off on the snacks for a bit and just enjoy the atmosphere. Nothing says Halloween like a ride on Winnie the Pooh. Someone is at the Emporium to check out some of their other merchandise that I missed, but they had some pretty neat, not so scary pins. They had a few different variations of it, but they were $20 a pin, which a little pricey. So I wanted three of them, but I think I might skip out on it for now. Right here in the window displays on Main Street, we'll just get a good view of all of their Halloween merchandise. Like the Starbucks cup is in there, pumpkins. So that is a smaller pumpkin than it was last year. Last year was a lot bigger, but I think it was a little bit more money, but I think for the price difference, it makes more sense to have gotten the bigger one. Here's a full window display for the Haunted Mansion. So it shows off some of like their different bags in there, some little sweatshirts. And then they also have the Nightmare Before Christmas. This little like display figurine is pretty cool, Jack and Sally. Like almost firework time. And then we'll wait up here for the next parade. Alright, so we have about an hour until the next parade, so take them to hit Pirates one more time and then we'll come back up here and wait it out for the parade. The camel almost got me. I think it got me the last time I was here, but it just missed that time around. I always forget that they keep it on for the Halloween party, so it'll just sneak up on you. Pirates looks so nice lit up for, not so scary, with a nice blue light. Up there's Jack Sparrow. Looks like we're gonna have another walk on here on Pirates. So I get to enjoy one of my favorite rides again and with no wait.
Strike your feathers, dearie. Show them your flock.
Hey, send them hens a day.
By thunder, that scoundrel Captain Jack Sparrow will never lay eyes on it, nor this here king.
Yes, it's a fine treasure indeed. Is that not true, my chromatic winged beast? Drink out me,
soon may the weather and come bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Alright, so not too much longer until the parade starts. Looks like we have about 30 minutes. So let me see if I can find a decent spot down Main Street, closer to the exit, so once it ends, I kind of just head on out. So I think it's getting pretty late and getting tired. I'm gonna go lay down and drink some water.
It's
do if we're trying to go through the crowds. Right, a race to the buses. Hopefully, not all these people are going to Palm Century. Hopefully, they're going everywhere else but Palm Century. I'd get a quick bus. Definitely need a shower. It's been a sweaty one today. All right, made it back to the room. Lucked out. If I left 10 minutes later, it would have been waiting in line forever for those buses, but got lucky, got there in time, a very short wait, got on the bus, got back to the hotel. But overall, great night. Was able to catch the shows, try a few different new food items that I never tried before. Got really full, so I wish I could try more, but could only eat so much in one night. But yeah, I was able to get on rides, eat some food, and enjoy some shows. So overall, great night. And with that being said, until next time.